kukabila ndio kwao. Hapo shafika kweli na hakika, kadiri na shika fura kwa lahiki. Kwa kwa shabiki, raji kuziki, beef na fiki, hit na dhiki. Muda muna wiki, mimi na himzi, split ni mukiki, doctor sika. Kwa makini mfulisa, mchima la sili, filmi, filmi.
You know, I sort of did not feel like making this video, but I'm it's something that I want to do, and I'm tongue twisted and stuttering, but with your help, I'm going to get through this because I don't have a lot of time nowadays to make videos. I have a little time, so I want to present as many as possible when I can get that break. Okay, let me get through this within the next 12 minutes or so. And it is always an honor that you would give me a chance to bring forth to you what you may call my opinion, but what I call real truth. Now, in this particular video, I am guessing. I believe. I'm not going to present facts and figures and things of this nature, but I am going to confess that this is all in guessing. But even in guessing, I truly feel I am on point due to a little of the history that I do know of. So the question I would like to present to us within these few minutes is, how did religion, how did so-called spirituality, how did these ideas, how did these beliefs become so powerful? Because it is natural not to acknowledge a God, just like it is natural to not acknowledge an apple that you've never seen, or a baseball cap that you've never seen. If your eyes do not see it, if your tongue cannot taste it, if your senses cannot interact with whatever it is, or there is a machine that can verify for you that something exists. Carbon monoxide gas is tasteless. It is odorless. How do we know that it exists? If you go into a room filled with carbon monoxide gas, you will learn the hard way. I have yet to walk into a room and learn the hard way that some God or some spirit exists. How am I supposed to know this? It is because it is a belief, unlike carbon monoxide gas. And these things were forced on us, although with good intent, from our parents. And it is something that has been acceptable within our society. It was forced upon us at birth. There was no attempt to tell you that this God is a belief. There was no attempt to tell you that there may be a possibility that this God, this creator, does not exist. And that is not fair to these children that y'all do this to every day, because basically you're telling them a lie. You're not giving them a choice. How did all this come about? Because you are also victims of this. How did all this come about? A young man, a brother, I assume, came to me and said that I should be ashamed of myself to profess a disbelief or do not acknowledge God when dark-skinned people in Africa and all over the earth, they exhibit a belief in a creator or supernatural being all over the planet, even prior to Europeans. He tells me that black people believe in God. And why is this? It is because prior to Europeans, that during ancient times, We must remember that ancient people were ignorant. And when you are ignorant and you don't know any better, anybody can tell you anything. And it still happens today. That's why they keep you dumbed down. That's why they keep us ignorant. Because ignorant people would embrace and believe anything. You would just take whatever is brought to you on face value and run with it. That's what happened. So the ancient people who were ignorant, who did not understand the sun, did not understand the grizzly bear, did not understand the earth, did not understand themselves, but they wanted answers. So somebody began to make up answers. And somebody began to find out that if you offer these answers, you can actually control the people. Because they are relying on you for answers to what they don't know. They're not even realizing that what is said is fabricated and made up. It has no foundation in reality. So at one time, because of fear, God was real. God was the sun. God was a grizzly bear. God was an alligator, and in some primitive people right now to this day, crocodiles and bears, these are their gods right now to this day. But as men began to educate themselves and find out that the sun is nothing but a ball of gas and they can take a bullet and shoot a crocodile and a bear, these gods were too weak. So now they began to use their imagination, and now God has become invisible. You can't comprehend, unlike the sun, unlike the bear, unlike the crocodile, you can see that God and feel that God and interact with that God. But this, now they created this new God, this new spiritual creator being. And of course, you have to have your connection. The ordinary ignorant person, you can't connect with the God, so you need a special divine pastor, a divine person to give you a connection to a father that we all supposed to come from. But this father, this God, plays favoritism because he, she, or it only will speak through the prophet, the messenger. You must be taught about this God because it's not natural. And since it must be taught, there are many people who are not ignorant. There are a lot of people right now today and in ancient times that were smarter than what they were given credit. And when the rulers found out that this religion, this spirituality could be used to control the masses rather than using armies all the time, you can control the masses by controlling what they think, how they believe. You didn't want these troublemakers to rise up in the ranks to mess with your slaves, because that's what it's all about. Religion and spirituality is nothing but a way to make you a slave, a servant to somebody. Either you are a slave to another man, or this spook, this invisible being that some man created that you believe. How was this done? So they began to kill the religions of peace. The religions that God loves everybody. All these religions that's supposed to teach all this love. In their origins, if you do a little research, you will find that they use violence. They use murder in order to spread their belief. In the infancy of the Christian church, they tried to do the right thing and just promote their belief, but it wasn't working. So they hired thugs, and they sent the thugs out to kill the pagans. They tried to please the pagans by mixing Christianity with paganism, but the pagans still did not want our Lord Jesus Christ, and they didn't want nothing to do with it. They just like celebrating and doing their own thing for whatever they was doing. So the Catholic Church hired thugs to murder, to kill. And like King Noble said, that's a fact. This is recorded. This is what was done. Like in all these other big shot religions, that's what they did. They murdered the disbelievers. And they definitely killed those who refused to believe in any kind of God, period. So I would be murdered. Those who will not acknowledge a God or believe in a certain God that the rulers decided this is what we're going to worship, you were killed, you were murdered, sacrificed to that God, tortured. What type of God are you serving? This is why I don't want anything to do with spirituality and God and the Creator. Nothing but slave-making teachings. Regardless to your race. If you Caucasian, you have been made a slave. Of course, if you have dark skin, you've been made a slave. You've been made a slave not only by Caucasian people, but other dark-skinned people even prior to them. You were a slave. You've been manipulated and exploited in the name of some kind of God. And in some cultures, they believe in human sacrifice. They were not sacrificing themselves. They'll grab somebody and cut open the chest and grab the heart and give it to their God. And their God never shows up to use the heart. All rituals, all insanity, all madness. And you think I want to be part of that. So as a child, I was taught this belief system, this belief in these gods as though it was a reality. But see, the thing about a free thinker, even as a child, I always was a free thinker. I knew something was wrong, but I just didn't know. Then I heard Bruce Lee say in his biography, someone asked him, did Bruce Lee believe in God? And Bruce said, when this God do the push-ups and the running and all this training that I do in order to be successful in this life, then I would acknowledge a God. I've never heard nobody talk like that before. And I really ignored it, but Bruce's words stayed on my mind because that was with me, but I still couldn't. I did not know that Bruce was called an atheist. And Bruce was not an atheist. He just did not acknowledge God. I am not an atheist. I just do not acknowledge God. And if you want to prove that God exists to me, then just like you would want to prove that an apple exists, send me some apple peel. Send me the apple. It's very simple. Put me in a room. I can smell the apple in the room. You can't present nothing except you show me that you are a slave. That's all that you show me. That you are ignorant. With all due respect, you're ignorant. But it's not your fault because these religions was forced on us at birth and taught to us like it's a reality when they're not. I want to thank all of you who are my soul brothers and sisters. You are not black. You are the people of soul. And a soul is just the essence of life. Soul is one that enjoys life. Soul is that which accepts the reality of life. A soul, brother and sister, that's what you was. And if you had stayed that way, you and I would have evolved and been on a higher plane. But since we are black, and we are spiritual, and we are Afro-Americans and all these different things that others have been influenced by our oppressor to call ourselves, then we remain in the same condition that we complain about, and that is in the condition of being a slave. I have 13 minutes. Let me quickly go through what I would like to present to us today. I want to try to explain this thing that we call spirituality. What is being spiritual? I hear that all the time. Nobody yet has been able to explain to me what spirituality really is. Because spirituality, as you know it, does not fit within the framework of the only reality that we know. That's why you can't explain it. So you cannot explain the unexplainable. But I would like to submit to you that whatever it is, those who don't acknowledge God, I'm not going to say atheists, because atheists simply don't believe in God. So they acknowledge that there's some God, they just don't believe in it. I do not acknowledge your God. What is it? I don't have no idea of what you're talking about. It's like I've never seen an orange or an apple, and you're trying to explain to me what those fruit are. I have never tasted one, never seen one, never heard anything about it. So I cannot say that I like an orange or an apple because I've never interacted, I've never been exposed to that. So I've never been exposed to your God. Unlike an atheist, I guess they can comprehend what you're saying. They just don't believe in what you're talking about. That's the difference between an atheist and myself. And myself, if you want to give me a title, of which I have no title, then call me a realist, one who just simply accepts my reality. Let's take this word, spiritual. Let's break it in half. The first word, spirit. Spirit is the essence of a dead person. Without someone who was once alive, you will not have a spirit. You do not have spirits without first there was a living person or being where that being, that flesh, died and released back into wherever, released the soul, I guess you could say, and now you have a spirit. It's the essence of a dead person. And then the second half of the word is ritual, which is the worship. Is a ritual is worship of something. So you have worship of the dead. And when you look at the background or the origins of the word, that's exactly what it is. It is the worship of the dead. The Egyptians worshiped the dead. Many ancient people worshiped the dead because they had a fear of the unknown. They had a fear of death. And because of that fear of the unknown and death, then they worshiped that which they did not know. And they began to fabricate and manufacture answers to soothe their fear. This is why you can't explain it, because spirituality really is in the realm of the dead. It's in the realm of the unknown. And when you call yourself spiritual and you are alive, how can you accurately explain this? It is not your reality. Reality will not permit that you explain something that is outside of your knowledge, something that is unknown, something that you actually have fear of. How can you explain your spirituality? Spirituality simply is your connection to life, is your connection to the world around you and to other human beings, even animals and plants, even the earth itself. You could see that in Native American people when they view this planet as Mother Earth. Even the rocks to them had life. Because that's spirituality to real things. although they did go into the realm of the unknown, they did do that. But more so, you had the people of this land in North America, where they had a connection to the animals and to the trees and to the even to the rocks. That's your spirituality, your connection to reality. But it's spiritual because you cannot see it. It's spiritual because you cannot taste it. You cannot touch it. But because you are part of this planet, because you are part of this earth, that's why, that's what makes us spiritual. Our connection to reality, our connection to life. You may not agree with that, and it makes no difference, but I can explain my spirituality. You cannot explain yours, because yours falls into the category of fiction and fantasy and delusions. We all come from the same place, and we always talk about the prophets and the messengers and these people that's so divine, yet and still, all your divine people came from the same place we all come from, and that is the womb of a woman. All of us came from that place, that dark place. But, and we all come into this world alone by ourselves. And we all come with what we need in order to function by ourselves alone. But for some reason, the divine person is better than you. The messenger and the prophet and all these people that y'all look up to, they are better than you, but they came from the same place that you came from. It's like an umbilical cord to your mother. We all have, you can even be twins, but we have separate umbilical cords to the source. And the source is this universe. The source is this planet. That's the source. And we all come from the same source. And we're all able to function on our own until we come into this life and you are tricked. And we are tricked and we have been conditioned to be somebody's slave. We begin to follow the same people that came from the same place that we come from. We follow the same people who's going to die just like you and I are going to do one day. They go to the bathroom and urinate and they pass feces and they stink and have bad breath and rotten teeth and everything that you go through, but they are special. They are divine. What makes them special and divine? You made them that way. You did it because you gave away your own divinity. You decided to disconnect your own spiritual self away from life itself and become somebody's slave. And when you give your life to somebody else, that's slavery. A slave only exists to benefit his or her master. So you worship this messenger or this prophet or even this God or whatever it is, you give yourself away so you can become a slave. We are all connected to the universe, coming from the same place. How are they more special than you are? They are special because you allow them to be that way. And we have been conditioned to be slaves. You have no idea of what freedom is. You talk about it and you scream about it and you holler and you foam at the mouth. I want my freedom and all, but you really don't know what it is. The only thing you know about is just exchanging one slave master for another one. You don't like Master Clark. You want to go to Master Gable's plantation. That's all we are doing. In religious teaching, spirituality is seen as an analogies. We use, I guess you could say, metaphors. I hope that I'm using the correct way, terminology. Wisdom is like water. Your wisdom should be able to be fluid, like water. Water changes. It can be a liquid. It can be a solid. It can be a gas. And that's what a spirit is. A spirit is all these different things. It cannot be touched. It's you can't destroy it. And you call your wisdom spiritual food. But at the same time, if you're going to call your religious belief spiritual food, then know that there is no food that you can eat that does not have feces, that does not have waste. So what in your teachings, what is in your belief system that is waste? What is in your belief system, in your teachings, that you should throw away? That you should have a bowel movement and let it go? You don't want to let none of it go. And what happens if you don't have a bowel movement? What happens when you refuse to urinate and get those poisons out your system? You have this world filled with religious believers believing in God, who's eating spiritual food, but they don't defecate. And thus they poison themselves. You don't have your connection. You can't find your own divinity. You can't find your own spirituality. Somebody been teaching you lies and falsehood, because you can't have true spirituality without reality. Spirituality, again, is nothing but your connection to life, your connection to the very place that you come from, out of. We are of this earth. We are of this reality. It's the only thing that we know. We don't know about ghosts and aliens and all these, and flying out your bodies and running around, all this imaginary stuff that y'all come up with. But you come up with it because you dwell in fiction and fantasy, and we've been trained like that ever since a child, fed Bugs Bunny and Superman and all this fictional stuff, garbage. And then when we grow to religion and these same fictional things are given to us, we embrace it like it's reality. It's the same stuff, except now it's given to adults. You don't even question your own religious beliefs, and talking about ghosts and goblins. People see ghosts and the ghosts wear clothes. What do a ghost need clothes for? Is there a JCPenney in heaven? Is there a Macy's in the afterlife? Come on, y'all. It's your imagination. You can't go outside of your reality. So everything that you come up with has to be based and founded in the only thing that you and I know, and that is reality. That's why you have a problem in explaining your spirituality, because it conflicts with the only thing that you know, and that is this life that we was given. Whether you like it or not, I'm telling you the truth. You need to stop talking to these liars who's feeding your emotion, because there's a benefit to them to keep you and me a slave. again, I want to make very clear that the top priority of this ministry is the awakening and the liberation of the minds of these who are the descendants of slaves born in America having dark skin. However, real truth has no color. Real truth is a benefit to all who will embrace it. It is not my job to teach Caucasian people anything. You have plenty of teachers. You have professors in high schools of learning and everything that you need. You don't need my help. But you are a rejecter of truth. You don't like hearing the truth. And that is sad, because it would make your world better. And you really would be the righteous and holy and just people that you right now are delusional in, if you accepted the truth and acted upon that truth. You could actually be that people in your mind, in your delusional mind, fictional mind, you think you are right now, but you're nowhere close to. I'm speaking to the Caucasian pink people of America. And just saying that, people talk of, they will say, oh, that's racist. There's, you call yourself Caucasian and you look pink or red looking, you're so, what's racist about that? You call me black. I'm not, clearly I'm not black. Wear something black. I'm not black. And you know what the word black means in the English language. So you can call people and describe people and label people, but you don't want nobody to call you or label you anything. What's up with that? In fact, I have not spoken about Caucasian people in a long time. If you look at the library of my videos, although most of them on YouTube have been destroyed, you will find that I don't talk and speak about Caucasian people too much, really. You are the creators of the problem. I'm not saying you as an individual. I'm saying you as your government, you as your ancestors in the past, you as those who are present right now, who continue the ways of your ancestors in the past, who have evolved racism so that it's not outright in your face. It's undercover, and you know this. So when somebody calls you racist, you know that that's very difficult to prove. So you say, that's racist. I prove it. In the movie Training Day, Denzel Washington said, it's not what you know, it's what you can prove. And see, that's how you try to get black folks. When they call you racist and try to show you you're wrong and the racism, because it's not what you know, it's what you can prove. And how racism has been set up, it's in education, it's in law enforcement, it's in media, it's everywhere. How can you prove these things? Because racism is a way of life. Proven. This is the way it's always been. How do you know if I'm a racist? You just not talented enough to hire. But I don't talk about Caucasian people that much. But I do make clear that it was Caucasian races that created the problem and still continue their award-winning ways. But it is we who are dark-skinned people born in America, descendants of slaves, we keep ourselves in because we reject truth and we have faith and love in those who caused the problem to begin with. We have faith that our abuser would change their award-winning ways. It is going on 500 years. They have yet to change anything. What we find ourselves in as dark-skinned people in this nation, we are involved in a almost 500-year-old abusive relationship. And we're living with abusers. An abuser will attempt to justify what they have done to the victim. In fact, abusers try to blame the victim for what the abuser has done to them. Well, I would not punch you. I would not punch you in the face if dinner was on the table when it should have been. You know I work all day. You caused this. Yeah, I slapped the child. I told the child to do what I say. But the child didn't do it immediately like I wanted. So I slapped the child around. The abuser always tried to blame the victim. If the victim didn't do this and the victim didn't do that, then I would not have had to hang you from a tree. If black people had done this, I would not discriminate against you. If black people had done that, I would not have raped your daughter. The abuser always tries to justify their action. We are in an abusive relationship. And the abuser always tell the victim, I'm going to do better. I ain't going to hit you again. Forgive me. Forgive us. You live in the United Snakes of America. And this government that made slavery legal, Jim Crow legal, that supported the Black Codes. Most Caucasian people don't even know anything about the Black Codes. This government has offered no apology, shown no remorse, offered no reparations. If you get an animal out of the forest, an eagle, you take that eagle, the wing is hurt, you wrap that eagle up, and then when you think that eagle is healed, you try to train the eagle so it can fly like it's supposed to, and you release that eagle back into the wild. This government, this nation had black people for over 300 years. And then you just set our people free. You offered no band-aids. You offered no training. You knew that these people are not Europeans. They were Africans or whatever we are supposed to be. You're supposed to heal us, return us back to Africa, show us our heritage, heal the damage that you caused. In court, you do not win an excessive amount of anything. In court, you go to court so that you are made whole again. So black people want reparations, not because we can be super rich and flaunt and drive 10 Cadillacs at a time and all this other nonsense. The government and the businesses that benefited from slavery need to make this people, of whom you have caused extreme damage to for over 300 years, you need to make us whole. But since you're an abuser and you're a liar and a murderer, just like Malcolm X said, you can expect good out of evil. You're evil and wicked, and you enjoy this abuse that you put on black folks, and you laugh at us. It is so sad. I had a Caucasian person tell me that my ancestors would be ashamed because of how I talk. My ancestors would be very proud because they were not brave enough. They did not have the knowledge. They were not in a position to say and do what I say today. But because of their suffering, I stand on their back. And it is my job in this time to become better than what they were and make sure that the next generation becomes better than what I am. What kind of nonsense is that? you're going to tell me my ancestors would be shamed while they are in shackles and being mistreated like they were in love with that condition? Are you sick? But that's the sickness of some of these Caucasian people. Caucasian people don't want to embrace the truth so much that they even talk about, my people was enslaved. They were white slaves. Now, here you are. This is the ironic thing about it, is that you keep telling black folks, stop being victims, stop being victims. But if there is a chance that black people, dark-skinned people in this nation could get reparation, you want to play victim too. Well, let me tell you something. We don't have nothing to do with your victimization. You need to go talk to the ones who enslaved you. And that's your problem. That's your business. You're getting in our business. And the reason why you are in our business, because you think that we're going to get something for nothing. That shows you how trivial you view what happened to my ancestors, our people, in slavery, of which it still continues till this day, as our young boys and girls are being shot down and murdered in the street. It hurts. And you don't understand, how can black folks continue to speak the way that we do, even though you killed Malcolm X? And when I say you, I'm just talking in general. I'm not talking to you as an individual. Some of you weren't even born during the time of Malcolm X and Martin King, but you murdered the Black Panthers and you murdered Malcolm and you deported Marcus Garvey and you kill our leaders, but yet and still, we always rise up. Somebody always rises up to talk and speak. That's because this is wrong. Even if we were Caucasian, the human being is going to rise. It is not meant for the human being to be a slave under nobody and be oppressed. It is meant for us to be free. So I don't care who it is. But it hurts. I understand. Truth hurts. In this nation was built on murder and lies and theft. This Caucasian person was talking about, they don't believe all the things that I say about Caucasian people stealing from black folks. And I don't care what you believe and what you know. The information is there. If you want to know, look it up. It's not for me to teach you anything. You don't want to know anyway, because you want to live in your delusion. And your self-righteousness, you're an abuser. And when you see abusers, that's how they are. They all high and mighty and with their chest all poked out. But in reality, they're nothing but a bunch of cowards and a bunch of punks. Because when the law comes after them, or when the victim decides, I can't, they're not going to take it no more, start kicking the victim, the abuser, the perpetrator, the real perpetrator in the backside, you ought to see how punkified they really are. So with that said, I would suggest and advise to Caucasian people, you really need to get off your high horse and embrace the truth. It is good for you. It hurts. I know. Come on. Look. It hurts on both sides. It hurts to hear the truth. As a victim, it hurts being a part or being classified as a perpetrator, abuser. But when we accept the reality of things and embrace it and then sincerely want to try to heal what has happened and stop thinking about all the money and the material things, that don't mean nothing. All of it would be much, much better for everybody involved. And through our example, through your example, you can be like what Michael Jackson said in the song. You in reality can heal the world. But right now, only thing that you can do is be a destroyer. Holy Quran, and you're limited to Holy Bible and the Torah and all these books of religion. They can only take you so far. Their truth can only take you so far. And it stems not in our reality, but in a world of fiction and fantasy that you really can't relate to. That's why when you're questioned, they always say, you don't question God. Because you cannot question which that you can't explain, because what you're trying to explain does not really exist in your reality. And see, these are truths that must be known not only to we who are the descendants of slaves born in America having dark skin, but it is something that all humanity needs to learn and know about and come up out of these forms of slavery that we find ourselves in. Now, it is not my job. In this video, the topic is Caucasian people cannot handle the real truth. This is true. We see it day in and day out. You can't post a video speaking about Caucasian people or make something, a statement that they don't like. You can't even be Beyonce and just put on a show that is not real. And they get all upset because they don't want to accept any kind of reality of what we're facing and how we're living. They want to live in these delusions where they are the holy and the righteous and everything is going just fine and dandy. And somebody like Beyonce that just makes a little statement, not really saying anything, not really showing anything that has not been shown before, but coming from somebody they thought was 1,000% their slave, it makes them very upset. So we will boycott Beyonce. And those who don't want to hurt Caucasian people's feelings, these who have black skin, they also want to join and try to boycott Beyonce. But however, you know, her fan base is too strong and the boycott Beyonce thing ain't really, you know, working. We need to be able to become adults and we need to be able to accept things about us. We should be able to accept the truth about us. Someone told me in a very nice way that my breath stinks. Either I can accept that truth or I can reject that truth. I decided to accept that truth because I did not want to go around with a foul mouth. So that's a benefit and it's good for me because now that the people that I'm greeting, I'm not going to turn them off with bad breath, right? But however, if I want to be, I can smell my own breath. It don't stink to me. You know how you cough in your hand or whatever and you want to deny that your breath stink or whatever. Whether or not somebody has told you this, you need to take this into consideration. But we don't want to take anything in consideration. Matter of fact, you are insulting me. So all day long, I'm running around talking to people. And as you speak to them, they sort of turn their head in the opposite direction because they don't want to smell your stinky breath. Caucasian people in America, you have stinky breath. You stink. You have become a skunk, not only in America, but all over this planet. And you're rich and with this stench and you're foul. This is something that you don't want to deal with. This is something that you don't want to face. But if you did, things would go much better than you. And this is not to talk about all. Some people talk about all. I prefer not to talk about all because that would not be true. And since I stand on real truth, to say all would be wrong. And since I stand on real truth, I must be fair and just regardless to how I am treated, because in this nation, Lord knows, I don't believe in Lord. It's just a saying that we always use. But I have been treated very unjust, especially in the legal system in this nation. However, I'm not going to be like those I complain about. So you deny me justice, but I will treat you as fair as possible. So those Caucasian people, those white people, I prefer to say pink or Caucasian because definitely you're not white. White in the English language means pure, holy, righteous, and we know, and you know, that you are not these things, and clean, and we definitely know you're not clean. So the Caucasian and pink people, those who have been listening to my videos for years, yes, that's right, there are Caucasian people who follow this page, whether Google tears my page down or whatever, they will find my videos, these Caucasian people, and they listen to me, and they have been listening to me ever since I've had this channel called Angel Snubnub 7, this ministry I call The Realities Temple on Earth. They know that my top priority is speaking to these who are the descendants of slaves, born in America, having dark skin, but yet and still, see, yet and still, they can overlook all that and see the truth that I'm speaking. And that truth makes us better regardless, because truth has no skin color. Truth has no foundation in some country. It's not American, it's not British, it's not Somalian. Truth is truth, and every human being on this planet has the right to hear the truth. Whether you accept it or reject it, that's on you. But all of us have the right to listen and be presented before us real truth. And in religious texts, it says that truth shall set you free. But all over this planet, you don't see free people. And the Bible is there, and the Quran is there, and the Torah is there, all over this planet, but you really don't see free people. They are either slaves to another human being, they are slaves to money, they are slaves to oil, they are slaves to all these different material things, they are slaves to their penis, they are slaves to their vagina, they are slaves. There is nobody on this planet, rich, poor, literate, illiterate, homosexual, straight, regardless to where you find yourself, there is nobody free on this planet. All suffer from some kind of form of slavery. The money makes you more happier. You are a happy slave because you have more money. You are a happy slave because I'm the president of the United States. You are a happier slave. But when it's all said and done, we are all enslaved. As they say, and we do all agree, that there's only a small percentage of people that control the wealth and the media of this planet. I am not included. You're not included. And what they fear is your embrace and acceptance of reality, what I call real truth. And when Caucasian people who claim, I'm not like my forefathers, well then if you're not like your forefathers, sit back and shut up and listen to victims. Sit back and shut up and allow this real truth to come to you, and you examine it. And you can examine it, and you can dice it up, and whatever that you need to do, you'll find out that what is being said is indeed true. Either you want to change your condition and treat those who have been victims of racism and the abuse of this nation, not only in America, all over this planet, or either why don't you just admit that you enjoy the benefits and that having the advantage that your Caucasian pink skin get within a world built upon pink supremacy and racism. There is only one racism at this time, and that which was created by Europeans. Europeans created race all by themselves. The Chinese, Indians, nobody on this planet, black people, we had nothing to do with the creation of race. It all comes from Europeans. We have nothing to do with that. Because racism was created so that darker skinned people would become victims. And as long as racism exists, and you know this, as long as racism exists, somebody's going to continue to be enslaved. Somebody's going to continue to be oppressed. Somebody is always going to be a victim.